Jonathan Schrager for MixedMartialArts.com, joined today by Dustin Poirier. First of all, Dustin, how are we doing?
Good, man. Good. Having fun.
Good stuff. I imagine you've been inundated with this question, you know, throughout this whole media scrum, because you've got that insight now of having fought Conor McGregor. And like it or not, I mean, he is, you know, he's become a bit of a media phenomenon in his own right. You've been in the, you've shared the octagon with him. What was he like inside the octagon from a fighter's perspective? How good is he?
You know, the fight didn't go long enough for me to really assess how everything, you know, I didn't get to wrestle and go on the ground and have those transitions and those exchanges. But now he moves well. He's hard to read. His timing's different than everybody else's. He moves different. So, you know, he's good. He's good. He's a great athlete. He's fast.
Yeah, and is it, I mean, obviously, you know, there's a lot said in the lead up to that fight, a lot of animosity. Conor has alluded to the fact that he probably will move up to lightweight at some point. He finds the cut hard like yourself. Is it a fight you obviously want to avenge at some point? You're surging through the lightweight rankings now. He'll presumably do all right, you know, do fairly well in lightweight. So if it's a fight, that a rematch that probably will happen down the line.
Good, let's do it. I'm ready. I can't wait, you know. Maybe he'll do it after he loses this weekend and we can do it this next fight, you know. So I would love to do that.
And can I ask, touch upon that in a second, the fight this weekend? What amendments would you make? I know it's a question that kind of a bit cliche, but you know, how you said that he moves different, his time is different. How would you counteract that?
I would fight the same fight. Just wouldn't be as emotional as I was leading up to it, and you know, I was might have been blinded a little bit by the emotion and the anger, but I don't know. You know, I was ready to fight, and I think I just got caught. Yeah. But I'll make the adjustments in the fight. We didn't fight long enough for me to know exactly, you know, what adjustments that would be, but it'll be a different story if we fight again.
And when you did fight him in the build up, it was quite clear that, you know, for the first couple of weeks maybe, you know, you were finding him semi amusing, but as you probably cut him weight and that probably contributed, but then you got visibly more frustrated by him as the fight drew near. Do you think there's a fine line generally now within combat sports between hyping a fight and actually overstepping the mark with your comments?
You know, this is a combat sport, and we're individuals. If somebody wants to run their mouth, that's it's whatever, you know. It's up to the other guy to not let it affect him. There's no rules saying you can't, you know, it's freedom of speech. You say whatever you want to the other guy. Yeah. And that's what he was doing. And yeah, that's that, man. It's on the person who's being, you know, talked to not let it affect him.
Yeah. So there's no sense of, like, begrudgment on your behalf. You're not annoyed with the guy. If you saw him this week, for example, walking around, would you say hello to him?
I don't know. I'm sure I would, yeah.
Yeah. Wouldn't go out of your way to, but if you pass crossed, you'd maybe just...
Yeah, I wouldn't go out of my way to cut a line and tell him hi. But if me and him were walking and it was just us walking down a hallway, I would say, what's up, man? You know, he's doing a great job.
Cool. And you alluded to it before, your prediction. You believe Mendez wins this fight then. How do you believe he prevails?
I think he's going to use use that overhand that he throws a lot and use his wrestling. I think Conor's going to be on his back. He's never fought a guy like that, man. Mendez is a different breed. And he's got experience with five-round wars. So it's going to be good.
Do you think he finishes it within the distance?
No, I think Mendez is probably going to grind out a decision.
And obviously I've quizzed you a lot now on Conor. Just a little bit about yourself. Obviously you've moved up to lightweight, looking very impressive. Just in terms of time projections, what's your kind of, in terms of getting into the top five and what have you and competing at the elite level in the lightweight, what's your kind of projections in terms of times and the opponents you have to face to get there?
I have to fight somebody in the top 15 or top 10 to get there, I'm sure. So that's what I want to do next. You know, I want to be in the top 10 by the end of this year. Whether that takes me fighting one more time or two more times this year, I'm willing to do that. I'm just kind of sitting back right now, training, having fun, waiting on the UFC to let me know what's next.
And you're an understated guy. You're probably not someone who calls people out specifically, but any names in mind in the top 15 or top 10 that currently aren't booked up that you'd like to get in there with?
You know, whoever, really, man. You know, they do a great job, but fights that interest me are Michael Johnson, Eddie Alvarez, other guys who come to fight, you know, Edson Barbosa, guys who come to fight. That's who I want to fight.
Cool. Dustin, thanks for the time today.
Thanks.
Thank you, man. Jonathan Schrager for MixedMartialArts.com, joined today by Dustin Poirier. First of all, Dustin, how are we doing?
Good, man. Good. Having fun.
Good stuff. I imagine you've been inundated with this question, you know, throughout this whole media scrum, because you've got that insight now of having fought Conor McGregor. And like it or not, I mean, he is, you know, he's become a bit of a media phenomenon in his own right. You've been in the, you've shared the octagon with him. What was he like inside the octagon from a fighter's perspective? How good is he?
You know, the fight didn't go long enough for me to really assess how everything, you know, I didn't get to wrestle and go on the ground and have those transitions and those exchanges. But now he moves well. He's hard to read. His timing's different than everybody else's. He moves different. So, you know, he's good. He's good. He's a great athlete. He's fast.
Yeah, and is it, I mean, obviously, you know, there's a lot said in the lead up to that fight, a lot of animosity. Conor has alluded to the fact that he probably will move up to lightweight at some point. He finds the cut hard like yourself. Is it a fight you obviously want to avenge at some point? You're surging through the lightweight rankings now. He'll presumably do all right, you know, do fairly well in lightweight. So if you, it's a fight, that a rematch that probably will happen down the line.
Good, let's do it. I'm ready. I can't wait, you know. Maybe he'll do it after he loses this weekend and we can do it this next fight, you know. So I would love to do that.
And can I ask, touch upon that in a second, the fight this weekend. What are men this week, for example, walking around? Would you say hello to him?
I don't know. I don't know. I wouldn't. I'm sure I would, yeah.
Yeah. You wouldn't go out of your way to, but if your paths crossed, you'd maybe just...
Yeah, I wouldn't go out of my way to cut a line and tell him hi. But if me and him were walking and it was just us walking down a hallway, I would say, what's up, man? You know, you're doing a great... He's doing a great job.
Cool. And you alluded to it before, your prediction. You believe Mendes wins this fight then. How do you believe he prevails?
I think he's going to use his use that overhand that he throws a lot and use his wrestling. I think Conor's going to be on his back. He's never fought a guy like that, man. Mendes is a different breed. And he's got...
What do you make? I know it's a question that kind of a bit cliche, but you know how you said that he moves different, his time is different. How would you counteract that?
I would fight the same fight. Just wouldn't be as emotional as I was leading up to it, and you know, I was might have been blinded a little bit by the emotion and the anger, but I don't know. You know, I was ready to fight, and I think I just got caught. Yeah. But I'll make the adjustments in the fight. We didn't fight long enough for me to know exactly, you know, what adjustments that would be, but it'll be a different story if we fight again.
And when you did fight him in the build up, it was quite clear that, you know, for the first couple of weeks maybe, you know, you were finding him semi amusing, but as you probably cut him weight and that probably contributed, but then you got visibly more frustrated by him as the fight drew near. Do you think there's a fine line generally now within combat sports between hyping a fight and actually overstepping the mark with your comments?
You know, this is a combat sport, and we're individuals. If somebody wants to run their mouth, that's it's whatever. You know, it's up to the other guy to not let it affect him. There's no rules saying you can't, you know, it's freedom of speech. You say whatever you want to the other guy, and that's what he was doing. And yeah, that's that, man. It's on the person who's being, you know, talked to not let it affect him.
Yeah. So there's no sense of like begrudgment on your behalf. You're not annoyed with the guy. If you saw him.